Hello and welcome to the Vector Garden. In this video, we are going to take a look at this Metaball effect. And I'm currently seeing a lot of videos demonstrating it, but they are leaving out some crucial steps, and the most crucial step, they are doing it wrong. So we are going to take a look at the process. I'm going to show you each step, not leaving out anything important. And of course, we're going to take a look at where they are doing it wrong. Let's start with the base artwork, which is just a couple of circles. And let's take a look at the layers panel. There it is. So you see just circles, nothing else, no tricks, no appearances applied. So the target symbol shows no special appearances. And let's first take a look at how they are doing it. So what they are doing is select all of them and then go to Object, Compound Path, Make. So this is the mistake. We're going to see in a minute why this is a mistake. And then what is happening, we need effects. So let's go to Window Appearance and let's see what will happen here. And what now gets applied are two effects. So effect path offset path, like this. And we are just going to add some offset. And then in the next step, so what you need to do is take note how many you use. I use 10 millimeters. And in the next step, go to effect path offset path. Now Illustrator puts up a warning because we are using this effect, the same effect, a second time on the same object. And I have not clicked don't show again because I want to see this error, apply a new effect, because we want. Now we need to just reduce the offset by the same amount. So basically the circles get the same size, and you need to set this to round in order to get these metaballs, just like that. Okay, and now nothing has changed, but it will. What you now need to do is move them around in order to get this. So there are two things you can do. You can enter isolation mode by double clicking this, and then you see that gray line at the top of the screen. And I think this is what happens in most of those videos. And then you can select them, and then you see this is happening here. If you do not enter isolation mode, you can of course do that as well, but then you need the group selection tool. You need to make sure you click exactly on the path of such one. So you see it's just one of them selected, then you can move one of them around and the same thing happens. So, and then we can move them closer together, just like this. Now the issue with the compound path is the following. In some cases it might happen that you get this kind of overlap. So too close together, and then you see this is happening. So the next step that is shown in a lot of videos is you want to add a circle to that. In order to do that, you actually need to enter isolation mode. So just double click this, then you are in isolation mode, and then you can add some circles to it. So draw a new circle, and then you see it connects at some sides. So let's move it here, and then you see you get these overlaps. They are kind of uncontrollable, just like this. So let's take a look at how to make this without getting these uncontrollable overlaps. I'm going to exit isolation mode by double clicking anywhere on the screen, and then let's select this and let's release it. So go to Object, Compound Path, Release, and we have the circles. Now let's select all of the circles because they all now have something applied in the appearance panel. You see they all have the offset path, so we need to get rid of that. Let's select just these two and delete them. So to get the correct version of this, select all of them, and then what we need to do is another kind of compound object. So what we need to have is a compound shape. And those are created with the Pathfinder panel. So let's go to Window Pathfinder. And we need to combine them, but not by just clicking here, but pressing the Alt key and then clicking. And you see we have a compound shape in the Layers panel. There are the circles in it. And the next thing, just as already seen, so you go to Effect, Path, Offset Path, and then we enter the 10 millimeters, and then go to Offset Path again, apply the new effect, minus 10, and set this to round, of course, like this. And since we already have moved them closer together, we already get these overlaps. Now, again, you need to use either isolation mode or the group selection tool, but this time you do not need to click exactly on the path. You can just click anywhere on the object and move them. And you see, we do not get these overlaps. That just doesn't happen. You can move any one of these around and you do not get holes in there. So let's go to isolation mode again. I'm going to double click it. We are in isolation mode, and then you can draw some new ones and with the selection tool move them around and you see no overlaps. Now maybe you want to have overlaps, so what can you do then? And what we can do then, let's first select this one and get rid of those effects that happened because they get applied automatically. So let's go into the Appearance panel and set up new art as basic appearance. So when I'm now drawing new ones, they do not get effects like this. You see no effect. Now this one should overlap. So what can I do then? That's a nice thing with compound shapes. This is now, you see it's selected and it's also targeted. It has this double outline around the target symbol. So what we can do now is apply a shape mode to this. So the complete thing has the shape mode Unite applied. This puts them together. And we can target one of them and apply a different shape mode to it. So you press the Alt key and apply Exclude to that object. And then we are going to move this around and you see this circle now makes that kind of thing. And it's predictable. So with the compound path, we got this uncontrollable, but this time this is predictable because this shape has that mode applied to it. That is not shown, so you cannot see it in the Layers panel, and also it's not highlighted in the Pathfinder panel. But you have applied it to that shape and then you can have it. So that's how the Metaballs work and how you can do it right.